We're going off to Texas. Aaron, please don't talk too much about Texas because John's from there and he gets really excited.
I can go on and on if you want.
As most Texans can, Aaron. As most Texans can. Go ahead.
What's on your mind, buddy?
All right. So I'm 25. My dad passed a few months ago. I inherited – I wouldn't say inherited. I received a $300,000 life insurance policy, $800,000 401k, his house. It's worth $220,000. It's owed $90,000 on it. I'm really wanting to buy a house. I'm just wondering if I should put $200,000 down on a house that's $370,000 or what I should do with all this money because I'm just blown away.
Yeah. Well, first of all, Aaron, my heart goes out to you, my friend. What happened with your dad?
He had a heart attack going to work.
Man, I hate that for you, Aaron.
Yeah,
were you guys close? Nuts.
Yeah, we were pretty close.
Were you? Do you have any other brothers or sisters?
No.
Just you, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Is your mother around?
Yeah, she's around.
Okay. And so you've been left with this dollar amount, and you're wanting to know, what do you do, right?
Exactly.
I would say this, you know, Aaron, first and foremost is understand an inheritance is something that was intentionally left to you. Okay, that meant your dad wanted you to have this stuff. And I think one of the most important things you could do is to be extremely intentional with it as you move forward. The home, are you living in this home right now?
No, I'm in an apartment currently.
Okay.
My lease is up in a week.
Okay, who's living in the home?
My mother is.
Okay, all right.
So you were left the home, but your mom still inhabits it?
Right, so he put everything in my name because she's disabled, and I guess he didn't trust her with money.
Okay. I want you to do something, my friend. Before you start to do anything with this, because typically there are laws about what a spouse can get at minimum. Now, you may be have what's called power of attorney. Mm-hmm. And may be the executor of this, but I want you to reach out to an attorney to really review the documents so you can understand what's actually yours versus what you have to keep an eye on for the sake of your mom. Does that make sense?
Yeah, correct.
Okay, because here's the deal. I don't want you to start making plans for this that you have to end up backing out. Mm-hmm. Because typically a spouse would get no less than a third. So let's just get some guidance, but let's say this. Let's say you walk through and what is in has been left to you is yours. I think you need to be extremely intentional, Aaron. And what I mean by that is you're 25 years old. You just had a serious loss in your life. The mindset can be to do some stuff to try to medicate.
Mm-hmm.
Or to do stuff to try to, you know, super honor your dad. And I think the best thing you could do is be very intentional, be very clear. I wouldn't buy a home until you're ready to be there at least 3 to 5 years. I wouldn't go out and buy a depreciable asset like, you know, a Ford 750 or anything like that. You want to be clear. You want to be calm. And so I would say park that money. If it gets liquid and it is yours, park it in a money market account. Let it sit there until you're crystal clear. I typically, when people get money from a loss of a family member or something like that, I typically say park that money for 3 months.
6 months.
3 to 6.
Yeah.
Don't do anything with it because odds are you're liable to be more emotional in what you do than rational. So that's what I'd do.
Yeah, and again, adding in the additional challenge of mom with special needs, a big chunk of that money may not be yours to spend as much to serve your mom. So finding an attorney, finding a SmartVestor Pro, someone to guide you through what to do with that money is going to be a big help.
Well, and here's the other thing, John. Let's take it a step further. If the dad has passed away unexpectedly and now, you know, you got Aaron who's now watching out for the mom, mm-hmm. this is the time where you have to take a look at setting up a trust.
That's exactly right.
Right? And with
the trust.
Yeah, right, because if something happens to him, who's taking care of mom?
Right.
Right? And so this becomes one of those things where it's a legacy mindset. And I know people don't like talking about dying, but here's the thing I know. There's a 100% chance, 100% chance we don't get out of this life alive.
That's right.
And so what we have to do is be grown up enough to do those things. And so, Aaron, as you reach out to that attorney, I want you to talk about a trust. Begin to think about who else could you establish as an executor of this for the sake of your mom. And, my friend, I just want you to take some long-term decisions. I tend to tell people, make two-year decisions. What I mean by that is make a decision today that you're going to look back on in 2 years, and you're glad that you made it. And what happens when you do that is you got to wake up. You got to kind of look out long term, John.
That's right.
You make 2 year decisions.
I try to. And if, when I find myself in a position where I'm not going to make a 2 year decision, I know enough about myself, wisdom wise, to have friends in my life, to have accountability in my life that are going to stop me and say, "Are you sure that's a good idea?" Right. My wife is a great example of somebody who will say, that's too short-sighted, John. Right. And this is one of those moments when Aaron, the 25-year-old, suddenly becomes Aaron, the guy that's got to make a bunch of decisions.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
The guy that just got to enjoy things and loved his old man and got to love on his mom. And now he's got to make some hard decisions. So get some wisdom in your life, brother. And this is one of those moments when you got to step up and grow up quick.
You really do. And you want to get the right people around you that can help you. And that's what I call building a dream team. You can read more about that at my website, chrishogan360.com.